This week's tutorial is one that I've been getting a ton of requests for, and it's one that I use in just about every single one of my videos. That is, of course, the effect where you track text onto your fingers. This is a great effect because it's practical, it looks really cool, and it's actually pretty simple, but it's only simple if you shoot the right way. While you're filming, you want to make sure that your hand stays in frame for the entirety of the time that you want the text to be shown. If your hand leaves frame, you won't be able to track the text onto it. It's also good to shoot with a high shutter speed. This will result in less motion blur and, consequently, a more accurate track. I've also found that it's quite helpful to move your hand or your fingers at the time you want the text to show up. Having that little bit of motion in the shot gives you a visual marker for where that track should start, and it also makes the effect just a little bit more convincing for the audience. Now that you have your footage, let's move on to creating the actual effect. Start out by making your footage into a new composite shot. After you've done that, head over to your control tab and make a new track on that footage. Use a single point track on the fingertip where you want that text to appear. Then add a new point layer to your composite shot and attach the track to that point. Finally, just add your text in and parent it to the point, and as you can see, the text appears to move with the tip of your finger. One final little touch that I like to add is this very quick animation. I start out by moving the anchor point of the text to be on the end of my finger, and then I animate the scale of the text to go from 0 to 100 over about 4 frames. Now, the text will scale from that anchor point, so if you move the anchor point to your fingertip, then it appears that the text is scaling from your finger. Yo, one quick final step that I forgot to mention is just to enable motion blur. Motion blur will just add that extra little layer of realism on top and help make it look like you're filming on an actual camera and not making an animation. So enable motion blur, it'll help out a lot. That's all. Finally, just keep the text nice and minimal. There's already a bit going on here with the motion tracking, so you don't need to add any more visual effects with a crazy drop shadow effect or a weird font. Just some boring white text with a nice modern font and no crazy drop shadow type effects is more than enough for this effect to look good. Anyway, I hope you learned something from this video, and if you did, do feel free to show your support by leaving a like on the video or even subscribing to my channel. I upload new filmmaking tutorials every single Saturday. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next one.